Hello, everybody. It's transfer deadline day. Delighted to say we have our resident expert in the studio, the magnificent George. Give him a round of applause, everybody. All footballers do this stretch. Just do that Sunday league stretch. Just do that one. I like that, James. What about this one? I've seen people do this before. This looks professional, doesn't it?
James.
Right. We ready?
Yeah.
Come on then. Here we go. Pace yourself, James. Pace yourself. George, the weird thing is you're actually going to interview me. This is quite scary. What do you want to know? James, I'm not sure you're going to survive at that pace.
You have covered a lot of sporting events. Which ones do you remember the most?
Well, that's a good question. I've been to quite a few Olympic Games, World Cups, European Championships, FA Cup Finals, golf tournaments, all that sort of stuff. I do think, I mean, I love football. I know you love football as well. I think probably the best thing that I've been to was the World Cup in Brazil in 2014, just because it was Brazil. The weather was amazing. Some of the games were great. England were rubbish, but they're always rubbish. But that was just an incredible event to be at. He's off. This is called Run with George. It's not Run without George.
It's transfer deadline day today.
It is.
Can you believe how much money has been spent?
It is a ridiculous amount of money, isn't it? And I think in recent years, we've probably thought transfer deadline day was slowing down a little bit. I know you're a big Liverpool fan and you want to sign Virgil van Dijk and probably Neymar and Messi and Ronaldo and everybody thrown in there together as well. But £200 million for Neymar, it is a crazy amount of cash when you consider as well that loads of fans are desperate to go and see football and they haven't got that much money. But I think the game just keeps growing and growing and growing and the fees keep going up and up and up. So it's good for football clubs and the people who own football clubs, but I'm not sure how good it is for the fans who get to go and watch the team every single week. When we do transfer deadline day here later, 10:45, this is where we'll do it. Trevor knows how much of an athlete I am.
What? Listen, if you don't beat him, I'm disappointed. Although his strides are about four. One to your four.
He's actually doing an amazing thing. This is James's brother, right. And he's running a mile with different people for every single month that James has been alive, because raising money for Old Hay Hospital. So wow. This is your 80th mile.
What an
mile,
amazing goodbye. Thing to do.
Yeah. How much have you raised so far, George?
I've raised what have I raised again? Like 37,000.
That is absolutely amazing.
Great, isn't it?
Three, two, one, push.
Here's a quick look at some of the action on BBC Sport this weekend.
We're going to come. We're going to come and meet you in a moment.
Excellent.
Brother James.
James, hello, James. Pleased to meet you.
So this is what's. You see yourself on here. This is when you worry, because that's what's going out right now. Okay. If I see you four pop up on there, you're basically live on telly. So you have to start talking. All right.
So if you press with your foot, so that's it. You see it, and then you can. You can normally roll it to your own liking, your own pace.
Do you want to have a go?
Let's have a go, Ian.
We are rapidly approaching the end of the series.
Yeah, push down, that's it. Transfer deadline. Brilliant.
Things being too hot as Premier League moves ahead.
Come on, George, we're feeling. Now, I want you to be honest about my technique. How does it compare with some of the other people that you've run with? I know it's not about how fast, it's about how much money we've raised, but I'd like to get your insight if possible. My wife says I'm a plodder and I don't run properly.
No, you're fine.
Oh, thank you.
You're amazing.
How fast can you answer some questions?
25 seconds.
Let's see. So I'll start the timer in 3, 2, 1. Do you have a hobby?
Yes, football.
Where's your favourite place to go on holiday?
Sheffield.
Who's your favourite singer?
Adele.
What did you want to be when you were young?
A footballer.
What two things would you take on a desert island?
A Bible and a football.
What's your favourite food?
Curry.
Who makes you laugh?
John Bishop.
Merton. Who would you most like to meet?
I would have liked to meet Muhammad Ali.
Okay. What is your favourite TV show?
Whose Line Is It Anyway? From a long time ago.
What is your most treasured possession?
Golf clubs.
Now we've finished.
Look at that, come on. That's got to be in time, surely. To do pre-season predictions for the BBC website, and I put Manchester United second but Manchester City first.
Yeah.
And then I think I had Chelsea and Spurs. I didn't even have Liverpool in the top four, George, sorry about that. But I think Manchester City at the moment will win the title, but I don't think I've ever got it right, so who knows, maybe Manchester United will be right, maybe Liverpool will come good and they'll win it, George.
Fingers crossed.
Okay. Fingers crossed for George and his team. So, how many miles is this we're doing? This is number, shall we, Dad, 80.
80.
Number 80. So you've actually run 80 miles in total.
Yeah.
You're raising money for All the Hay.
Yeah.
And just remind us, because most people watching this will know.
Where's James, your brother?
James is back there. What happened to James?
He stopped breathing. So we rushed into All the Hay.
They saved his life.
They saved his life, yeah. And I want to say a big thank you by running a mile for everyone who led him.
So we're on 80 months at the moment.
Yeah.
Right, excuse me. Trying to get to 100 miles.
Winning a race between you and Louise Minchin.
What sort of race are we talking? Is it a sprint or a marathon?
Probably
say
sprint, really.
A sprint. I'm pretty confident I could win a sprint against Louise, but you know she's a triathlete, so she swims, she cycles, and she runs, and she's even representing Great Britain in her age group. So, I think I might have to say if it's a long distance race, I think Minchin will probably take the biscuit. But 100 metres, George. I mean, come on. You've seen my running prowess.
Yeah.
You know that I've got the skills, yeah?
Yeah.
You see, skills pay the bills. You heard it here first, George. Thank you very much. Very nice to meet you, by the way. It's a bit hilly, this bit, George.
Yeah.
Right, I'm going to sign off at this point because it's no longer easy to hold this, to breathe, and to run at the same time. Over and out. Technique, George, technique!
Thank you so much, Dan, for running.
It's a real pleasure. I've very much enjoyed myself. Thank you.
Do you know who you want to nominate?
I do know who I'd like to nominate. Do you want me to do it down the camera?
Yeah.
I'll give you a clue. You've met him already. Okay. George, ladies and gentlemen, James and the rest of the family, I would like to nominate TV's Mike Bushell. Listen, with Mike Bushell, he looks quite fit. If you ever see him do breakfast television, he looks like he's got a bit about him. Make sure you push him. Hey, James, go off really nice and early. Get that sprint starting. Make sure you test him physically. I don't want him to finish.
Okay.
For him to think he's not being put through it by you lot. All right. And if he beats my time in that 10-question challenge, I'm going to genuinely be disgusted.
Thank you so much, Dan.
Boys, it's been an absolute pleasure. It's been lovely to meet
no
you.
Problem.
Hopefully, you get to 100 miles and you keep raising money for an amazing hospital.
That's my objective.
Okay, well, Mike Bushell will make it to 81 and then just keep going from there. And by the time you finish, Liverpool might have won a game. It's a joke. Hello, everybody. Dan Walker here, delighted to say I have completed my run with George. Please do support him. You can go to his website, runwithgeorge.com. There's a little thing on there, you just have to click donate and you can get involved. The other best way to do things is you can actually just text the word George, it's that simple, to 70660, 70660, and that will give £3 direct to the charity. And all that money supports the magnificent Alder Hey Children's Hospital. If you don't know much about it, look it up. It is a truly amazing place, and it saved his brother James's life. Well worth a bit of your time and hopefully a bit of your money as well. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again soon.